We're at the scene right now in Madison, Wisconsin, outside the state capitol. Protesters gathering, not happy with a governor who says the state is now open for business. Scott Walker on the right saying that this union crackdown bill that he signed into law is not something that is going to go against public workers, but something in the interest of state taxpayers. But the protesters are planning a massive rally tomorrow outside the capitol in Madison. They're going after everybody to make their views known, including this next fellow, Wisconsin Republican State Senator Dan Kopenke, who actually had protesters and probably still does outside his house. Senator, were they there?
They are here as we speak, Neil, and I expect the numbers to ramp up here in the next probably an hour.
So they're outside your house. I mean, how many of them are there?
Well, initially there's about 30 of them, but it was supposed to start at 3:30 our time, so they're 5 minutes early. And again, I expect it to be peak numbers probably in an hour or 45 minutes.
And what are they saying, doing, anything?
Well, I'm up for a recall as our seven other state senators. So they're chanting recall and workers' rights protections and union protections and all of that. And I think it's kind of ironic. I got an agenda of what they were going to do here, and they were ordered to wear black today for their cause. And I think it's interesting in light of what's going on in Japan that they're wearing black for contributing to their pension fund and their benefit fund and having some of their collective bargaining rights stripped away and making Wisconsin a better place to do business and work and live. And they're wearing black for themselves when we have a Japan in such a horrific situation over there.
Are there police there?
Yes, we have police here, and I'm sure it'll be peaceful. And, you know, they have every right to voice their opinions and their concerns. I'm open for that. That's part of our democratic process, and as long as they're peaceful and they can gather here for as long as they want, I'm thinking of taking some cookies out there for them and maybe some hot chocolate.
Do you have kids, Senator?
I have kids, but they're older, and I've got grandkids that I worry more about.
All right, so are they coming in and out of the driveway? Are they getting taunted or anything?
No.
Okay.
It's at this point, it's peaceful. Again, in another hour, we'll see where it goes, but I'm sure it'll be fine.
All right. Well, we're told from public workers and union leaders that they don't want it to be fine, at least in the state. They're calling for a general workers' strike and that things are not going to settle down. They're actually going to get worse, and the state's going to ground to a halt. What do you make of that?
I think that's pretty sad. In fact, there's letters written, threatening letters to business owners who supported Governor Walker and myself in the recent campaign that if they don't back down in their position with the governor and with this bill that they're going to boycott their business. Very threatening letters. I've seen a copy of one, and it's all unfortunate. I mean, this is America, and if a business owner wants to support a particular candidate, I think that's all part of our American political process, and it's unfortunate it's come to this to this extent.
Well, as long as people don't get crazy here, just be safe, Senator. All right. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Neil.